Peter, you are a rock. And on this rock foundation, I will build my church. And not even death will ever be able to overcome it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. We ask you to bless Father Domingo Gonsalves and Monsi Nelikunel, who are taking up their responsibility as executive secretaries for catechesis and liturgy. Also thank you for the gift of Father Iris Fernandez, who have worked tirelessly in this house as administrator and executive secretary for the...
He's our very vibrant deputy secretary general, very hardworking. And this function, he's the one who has been planning it for a long time, sent to me all the details, planned every detail to it, very minutely, the prayer service. Father Stephen, I welcome you. We are happy to have you. As far as saying to renovate a new house and to do so while staying, I think initial stages, Father Iris stayed in Divine Providence Convent, but then later I think you shifted and he had to face a lot of difficulties. We are deeply grateful to you. May God bless you, Father Iris, and I'm happy that you will continue for some more time in Goa, Mafsa, where he will be till the end of May. It's not very far. Goa is small. We can easily travel. I hope you will continue to keep in touch, not only with this house, but I know you have quite some friends in Benavli. Yes. Now, Father Domingo, you are taking over today. I wish you all the best. And it's quite meaningful that we are going to have the release of the directory, or the directory, maybe I'll say one word later. But I wish you all the best. You are not a stranger here. I think not to Shanti Sadan, not to Goa. I also know that you have quite some friends here in Goa.
Yes.
Quite some have mentioned Father Domingo is coming. We know him. He's our friend. So may friendships grow and increase. Now I want to end by making a few remarks. Having it today on 1st of October, having it on the occasion in this place of St. Joseph Vaz, and on this day when we celebrate the feast of Saint Teresa of Child Jesus. First, Saint Joseph Vaz. CCBI, all the commissions, all of us priests, nuns, laity, we are called by Jesus to evangelize. And Saint Joseph Vaz is a shining example of evangelization. He was a man on fire. I like to think of these two great evangelizers, both connected with Goa, St. Francis Xavier and St. Joseph Vaz. Two powerful evangelizers. And to my mind, St. Joseph Vaz is a greater example for us today, the church in India. Because St. Francis Xavier, great evangelizer, but he had the backing, he was the papal legate, he had the backing of the powerful Society of Jesus. No, it was a different context. Today we are facing different times in Asia, in India, we know, where we have to work as a leavenness. We cannot go the way things were 500 years ago. We have to work as a small mustard seed, as a leaven. And that's what Joseph Vaz did. He went to a hostile environment of Sri Lanka at that time. Hostile because the Calvinists were harassing the Christians. They had driven away all the priests. And he went there with the power of the Spirit. In all simplicity, in all humility, in all commitment to Jesus, the advice that he had given to his nephew, for me that's a beautiful example for every missionary, for every priest, for every bishop and for every Christian. You know that beautiful story when his nephew was getting ordained. He was a deacon. It was a time where there were no mobile phones and internet. I don't know how many months the letter would take. And his nephew wrote a letter by post in those days, must have taken a couple of months, and asking his uncle for advice, I'm going to become a priest, please give me some advice which will hold me in good stead in my priestly life and ministry. And the title of that advice was, Jesus is the Son, S-U-N, Jesus Surya, Jesus is the sun. You be the moon. What is the mission of the moon? To absorb the light of the sun and to radiate. And that's our mission. As conference, as commissions, as secretaries, as administrators, as priests, as religious, to absorb the light of Jesus and to witness to. And Joseph Vaz did not give this advice only by word of mouth or through a letter. He lived it. He witnessed. He was a real witness of Jesus. He was a powerful faith formator, catechist, evangelizer. He evangelized the children, the youth, the families, the broken families. He had interreligious dialogue. He was such an evangelizer, man ahead of his time. I think it's meaningful that CCBI has this secretariat here in Benauli, where Joseph Vaz was born. He was born here, no?
Yes.
And baptized in this church. I think this house must remind us that we are called to be evangelizers, rooted in Jesus, passionately in love of proclaiming Him. We are having this function today, Feast of St. Teresa of Child Jesus. For us, persons of faith, nothing is coincidence, it is providence. She is patron of the missions, reminding us that those of us who are here, we cannot look at one another, we have to look at the mission of Jesus. And we have rightly said when you were taking oath, said that we will promote communion. The church is communion, and communion that is oriented towards mission. And I think it's very symbolical, you will be three here. I think Dumain, Monsi, and Milton, three, symbolizing the Trinitarian communion. And with a communion that is oriented to mission. Communion means collaboration. Communion means mutual appreciation. Communion means encouragement. Communion means forgiveness. Communion means maximizing the positives and minimizing the negatives. All of us, we are not saints, we are not angels. So I wish and pray that this community will be an inspiration to all of us, inspiration to this parish, oriented towards mission. And the third thing, we are having this in the month of Our Lady, Mother of the Missions, who shows us the way. And therefore, I entrust once again this house, I entrust all of you, Father Dumain, the new administrator, Father Milton and Father Monsi, who will be members of the community, Father Iris, who will continue to be associated with us. I entrust ourselves, this house, this parish, to the maternal protection of Blessed Virgin Mary. I would like to end where I began. Very special thanks to Father Stephen. Stephen, who does this work, is like the cog of the wheel. See, bishops, office bearers, we give advice, we say a few things, but somebody has to work around the clock. The wheel doesn't move unless the cog moves. He is like the cog of the wheel, constantly. And we feel that. I don't know how many times he phones to Father Loyola, phones to me, sends emails, always working, but with a great love for the church in India, with a sense of mission. I thank you, Father Stephen, and I would like to, once again, I think he deserves a clap. Appreciate Father Milton is our Executive Secretary of the CCBI Commission for the Family Apostolate, such an important thing, the Family Apostolate. He's working very earnestly. I want to thank Father Milton for the dedicated services you are rendering to this commission and to the conference, and also as a member of this community. I want to remember gratefully Sister Pieda. I'm in touch with her. Every week I phone to her, and I think she needs our prayers. Let us pray that she, for her complete recovery, so that she can come and join us. We are two representatives of her congregation, Sister Fatima, Sister Ignacia. We are grateful to you. Please convey our thanks to Sister Magdalene. Sister Shirley, I'm wondering, when you were saying that somebody from East Timor phoned to you and asked for the directory, maybe a member of her congregation. They have two communities as far as I know. Franciscan Hospitaller Sisters have two communities in East Timor. Probably that sister that phoned to you might be a member of a congregation.
Email I have there.
Could be.
Emails, yeah. Okay.
There are Jesus and Mary sisters also, yeah. But they are there. They have two active communities there. So thank you very much. God bless you and all our other collaborators. I see some new faces, but I'm sure you're also part of this family. Pashkwal, thank you very much.
This institution is not only for just for staying, but it's for meetings, seminars, and animation programs, catechetical, family, liturgical activities which will go on. For all this, it has to be kingdom of God, I believe. That is the purpose Jesus has come, and we all need to grow as the members.
So let us
be three but one in this institute, Father Monsi, Father Milton, and let us take it forward, not as my personal one commission, but as the for the conference. So let us shine, as already a lot of things are shared by Archbishop Lindley, Father Stephen Alathara from morning. It's all making us, encouraging us rather, to take up this challenging responsibilities here. So thank you. I will do my level best to serve the church in India through this institute.
And so after the meeting, I remember Stephen coming telling me, they want you to go. I said, well, if they want, that's one thing. I made a promise when I was ordained, never to say no. Whatever the superior said, yes, and go. God will be with you. And so when Father Stephen came and told me, they want you to go to Goa, I said, okay, they want, I will go. That's what I told Father Stephen, and that's how I came here. It was not an easy task. We came to first try it together. We met Mr. Pasquale through our great Monsignor, I call him, Nuncio Dias, and we saw the house. It was a jungle, real jungle here. I really would like to say again, Mr. Pasquale is a man of God. He's not an engineer only. Because when we entered this house, Father Lucy will remember, and Father Stephen will remember, I'm sure you might have seen the house before. There was a little room down there, the chapel. And the first thing he asked me, he said, you're a religious father, I have a question. I said, yeah, what's your question? He said, is this proper to have a chapel here and all the bathroom and washroom on top of it? That was his thought, the very first beginning. And then I said, no, we'll change everything. I remember I said, first thing, Mr. Pasquale, tomorrow you'll tell me it's rainy, we cannot work. Close these courtyards. There were courtyards here, openings where rain would come in. And that's what he did. And then he turned this FABC house into a wonderful house. One thing about him, Father Duming, never forget him. Anything you have, any problem, just call him up. He may not come.